So today we results market beta of 1.16, 0.210, 0.57. And this introduces copper to the game. So today we're going to be talking about everything that's part of this beta. This is available on Xbox One, Windows 10, and Android devices. And as always, changelog down below. Let's just go ahead and begin by taking a look at known issues, just so you know exactly what they know is broken. Now, first off, game ticks, they do not affect block states. So that means that crops will not grow without bone meal, and grass will not spread, etc. And this also includes copper oxidation. And they aim to fix this in the next beta. And also, loading a structure block that contains skulk sensors, it may crash the game. So please, stay away from skulk sensors until they are fully fixed up. But now let's just go ahead and take a look at copper itself. So we have copper ore. For copper generation, this is going to have the same rarity as iron. It can be from layer 4 up to layer 63. So it's exactly the same as iron, so you shouldn't have any problems finding this. But you can get copper ingots, which is obtained by smelting the copper ore. Drowns can also drop copper ingots instead of gold ingots. Then we have copper blocks, which is crafted from 4 copper ingots. There's also cut copper, which is crafted from 4 copper blocks. And right here, this is all the different copper blocks that we have inside the game. Right there is the normal copper. This is going to be the stuff that can oxidize. Then over here, we have waxed, which if you combine any of these corresponding copper blocks with a honeycomb, then you get yourself the waxed as the outcome. So let's say I go ahead and grab a hold of this regular copper block. If I come inside of here and I grab a hold of a honeycomb, I go ahead and check that right there, grab the copper block, and then voila, we have those waxed copper blocks. Now these, they will not oxidize whatsoever. They will stay the same as long as they're in your world. But for these, this can oxidize in between 50 to 82 micro days. But that is quite a long time for you to wait for it to oxidize. So if you want to be able to keep it at a certain stage, then I want to recommend making them waxed. It makes all the difference. Now next up, we have lightning rods. It says all lightning strikes that happen within a radius of 64 blocks from a lightning rod will strike the lightning rod. But do note that will only happen during a thunderstorm. But one really cool thing is that for the lightning rod, you can also use a channeling trident during a thunderstorm. You don't actually have to wait for the lightning to strike. You can just do it yourself. I'm going to go ahead and throw the trident right at the lightning rod. And there we go. It's now going to activate. Lightning rod that's struck by lightning will emit a full redstone signal for 8 game ticks. So as you saw earlier, whenever I strike this lightning rod, it did end up causing those lamps to turn on and off, which is really cool. So you can definitely make some really cool redstone mechanics out of those. I mean, I definitely cannot wait to see what people are going to do with lightning now. If you do want to find copper real easily in the creative inventory, you can just search up copper and you can find everything regarding copper. And one thing I like about this is that it's perfectly sorted. So on this side, it's going to be all the regular copper stuff. Then on this side, it's going to be all the waxed copper stuff. But with all that, that is it for everything regarding copper, and we're going to move on to the bug fixes. Now, first off, keyboard inputs can now adjust slider settings when the cursor is outside the UI frame. The screen reader now informs the player when the chat settings menu has been opened. They fixed a bug where the UI screen reader did not read the permission toggles titles on the permission screen. Screen reader now reads whisper and announcement messages. Improved the smoothness of the UI transition animations. Now they did improve performance for actors using temp goal. They fixed an issue preventing player interaction after using the clone command on a double chest block. Using the slash clone command to clone a block of the same type is no longer treated as a failed operation. They fixed players taking fall damage when opening a shulker box. Nether bricks now give XP when being smelted. All mobs that use a melee attack have had their ability to hit targets above and below them restored. The target still must be within melee attack distance to be hit. This only affects world versions greater than or equal to 1.16210. Redstone has been renamed to redstone dust instead of redstone. Let's go ahead and look at redstone. So now it is called redstone dust, which it makes a lot more sense than just calling it redstone. Tool and armor recipes now display the selected item background when selected. Wireframe of a structure block in the overworld will no longer render in the nether and end. Audio sliders will always now highlight. The durability bar is now visible when holding items with decreased durability in a window. And then for last changes, they added more helpful video setting messages for ray tracing supported and non-supported platforms. Structure blocks no longer autosave the data when the structure name text box is deselected. Now this is one I absolutely hated, because a lot of times I would have a structure that I already had saved, and then it ends up getting overwritten whenever I deselect the text box by accident, and then I have to go in and save the structure all over again, and it's just a very annoying bug, but that's not been fixed, so thank you Mojang. The scoreboard data of an entity is no longer removed if the entity is being teleported to an unloaded area of the world. Teleporting away from a structure block animation to unload it no longer causes the game to crash. And finally, this is going to be for add-on creators, a warning message now displays when attempting to move a locked item in and from containers. And with all that, that is it for everything that's part of this new beta of 1.16.210.57. Now, I do want to hear your thoughts down below in the comments about what you think of everything. Are you happy that we now have copper inside the game? And are you looking forward to the future betas of the game as well? I do hope you enjoyed today's video. If you thought this video was interesting and helpful, then let me know by leaving a like on it and subscribe so you never miss an upload. For now, I hope you have a logical day, and I will catch you next time. Bye!